Because I knew coming to write a novel like The Killing Lessons, it was going to require a different writing style. My natural inclination as a writer is to be digressive, a little bit ironic, parenthetical. Many of the other books that I've written are written in that style, not known for plot, for action, you know. But I knew that if you're writing a thriller, the clue is in the name. It has to be thrilling, which changes the writing style. So it's a very different writing style for me. So I thought, well, it's a different personality, a different writing personality. I'll have a different name. Psychologically, actually, it helped. More or less every book that I've published, of which there are now 12, they've all been quite different from each other. So with the exception of the werewolf books, which obviously three of those were, you know, a set, all the other ones have been quite different. So they've been different in content, in form. But in terms of theme, they've been consistent. I've always been writing about love, sex, death, evil, good, cruelty, compassion. So it just struck me as a bit absurd that in all those years, 20 years of writing, I'd never written a murder story. Because obviously, in a way, the crime novel or the murder novel or the suspense thriller, it's an obvious vehicle to look at many of the same themes. So I just thought, well, it's about time I had a go at that. But I came to it, you know, I haven't read very much crime fiction. I have not read very much modern crime fiction anyway. So I really didn't know what I was doing. I had to learn, or try and learn what I was doing whilst I was doing it. It's very difficult because I'm sure you're used to this when you talk to crime writers or thriller writers or mystery writers. It's very difficult to describe the plot without giving away crucial information. But essentially, it's the story of San Francisco homicide detective Valerie Hart. She has a troubled history and a drink problem and all kinds of mess in her life. And she is, when we start the novel, she is, there have been a series of killings that go back 3 years, which the police and the FBI have made very little progress with. The killer leaves behind in the bodies of his victim what appear to be random objects. But Valerie's job, obviously, is to figure out what the objects mean and why they're there and to try and use that to catch the killers. I've always been looking at deviant or extreme forms of human behavior, as well as the very ordinary things of love and friendship and, you know, humor and all the rest of it. And I think when you write a psychopathic character, you have a choice between two ways of doing it. You can do what Bram Stoker did in Dracula, or Thomas Harris with Hannibal Lecter in the first two books. You present the psychopath as a finished object. You know, we're not invited really to try and figure out why this person behaves in the way that he behaves. That's one way, kind of larger than life character. The other way is to create a character where the reader is invited to speculate on how this person might have ended up behaving in this way. And I wanted to have little seeds of explanation for that, or possible causes for that, through the novel. So it was important to me to keep the killer as a real person with a kind of history you could begin to understand. Not that that excuses the behavior, but that gives the reader some insight into how people end up doing these crazy things.